Hello friends, welcome to NetSetOS. Today we will see how to deploy a Ruby on Rails application on Google Cloud. So here in this video we will learn how to create a new Rails application using the Cloud Shell, how to test a Rails application using web preview in the Cloud Shell before deployment, how to add a welcome page to the Rails application. The fifth point is how to prepare your deployment configurations and how to deploy a new Rails application to Google App Engine. So let me brief you what an App Engine is. So Google App Engine flexible environment applications are easy to create, easy to maintain and easy to scale as your traffic and data store changes. With App Engine, there are no server to maintain. You simply upload your application and it's ready to go. App Engine applications automatically scale based on incoming traffic, load balancing, microservices, authorization, SQL and NoSQL databases, traffic splitting, logging, search, versioning, rollout and rollbacks, and security scanning are all supported natively and are highly customizable. So without wasting any time, now let's move to the console. So as you can see, by typing console.cloud.google.com, the Google console can be opened. You have to input your username and password. And before that, you have to create your own account for Google Cloud. So the first thing that you need to do is enabling the App Engine. So from left hand side, you can go to API and services. From there, you can go to enable API and services and you can search for App Engine. You can click on App Engine where you can manage it. For me, it is already enabled. If it is not enabled for you, then you can just enable it by clicking on the enable button. The next thing that we need to do is click on this Cloud Shell button. So you can clear the screen by typing clear if your console is not clear. So this tutorial is based on that you will have a basic knowledge of Ruby on Rails application and the deployment is very simple. As we have already discussed the deployment of Flask application, Zango applications on Google Cloud in our previous videos, you can check those videos also. So the first part is installing the Rails. As I have opened my UI and my Cloud Shell, so the first step that I will do is installing the Rails jam. So for that I can use the command jam install Rails. So it will say one jam installed. Now we can verify it by typing Rails --version. As you can see, we have verified it. We have downloaded the version 6.0.3.2. So now the first process is generating a new Rails application. So now that you have Rails installed, generate the new Rails application by running the following commands. Rails new and the name of your application. I will just type it as NetSetOS 1. It will take some time to get created. So wait for the time being. So deploying anything on App Engine is very simple. The process is working and it is downloading various dependencies of Rails. It is successfully done. So now what we will do, we will just cd into the folder or in the application that we have created. So we have created the NetSetOS 1. So after going into the application, we will just do a ls command and see what all files are there. You will see various things like app, bin, config.ru, jam file, lib, node modules, package.json and other folders and files that are important for the configuration of Rails application. Now we will run the following command to update our jam. That will be bundle install. After that, you will receive an update which will say bundle complete. Now, as we have done all the application creation and other stuffs, now let's see whether our application is ready or not. So we can run the command bundle exec rails server hyphen hyphen port 8080, and we will see a web preview also. So with the help of this web preview, you can go and click on preview on port 8080. It is for checking whether our installation and whether our setup is correct or not. Yay, we have got our Rails application deployed on local server. Now it's time to deploy it on App Engine so it is visible for all the people in the world. So the next step is we can add a customized welcome page for our application. So for that, we will go back to our cloud console and we will do a control C in the application. Now you will add a hello world page to the generated Rails application. You will generate the scaffolding for a new page by using Rails generate. The command will create a new Rails controller welcome with an action called index. For that, we will type bundle bundle execute Rails generate controller welcome index. This command will generate the following new directories and files by default for the new controller and action. So now let's modify the welcome page. For that, you can go to the NetSetOS 1, the application that you have created. Inside that, there will be an app folder. Inside the app folder, there will be a views. Inside the views, there will be a welcome. And inside that, there will be a index.html.erb. So here we can write welcome user and we can change the paragraph to something like that. This is our home page and welcome to NetSetOS, and save this page by Control S. Now we can finally set this new page as the root page for Rails. Whenever a user visits the Rails app, they will see your welcome index page. So for that, what we will do, we will go to roots.rb file for giving it where to search for our welcome page. For that, inside the NetSetOS 1 application, we will go to config. Inside the config, there will be a file roots.rb. For rooting this file, what we will do, we will add this line root welcome hash index. We can click on save. Now for testing this thing, we can again start listening on port number 8080. The command will be same, bundle execute rails server hyphen hyphen port 8080. We can go to the same page again and just refresh this page and our new welcome message will be there on the browser itself. As you can see, our welcome page has been changed from the default to our customized web page, and it's so much easy to test. As our local testing is done, now we will move our code to App Engine so that all can view our latest application. Now the final step will be deployment configuration. App Engine flexible environment uses a file called app.yaml to describe an application deployment configuration. If this file is not present, the gcloud tool will try to guess the deployment configuration. However, it is a good idea to provide this file because Rails requires a secret key in production. For generating the secret key, we will type the command bundle exec rails secret. There is a spelling mistake, so bundle. So as we have generated the secret key, now we will use the secret key in our configuration. To store the secret key, we will use the runtime configuration services. It is in conflict. So what I will do, I will just change the name by adding hyphen one. It is created successfully. Now we will add our secret key to this runtime configuration. So I will just copy paste the secret key that we have copied here and run this command, that is gcloud beta runtime hyphen config configs variables set hyphen hyphen config hyphen name and the configuration that you have created in our WSTAP, and then the secret key that we have created. I will just copy paste this command and run this. So now this has been created successfully. The main thing has come, the app.yaml file. So by clicking on the NetSetOS1 folder or the application that you have created, you have to create a file and click on new file and name it as app.yaml. Now we will define the entry point, environment, runtime, and other configurations in the app.yaml configuration. I have given you a sample in the description below. You can use this configuration. It's a very easy configuration file. If you see, there will be an entry point in which you will be defining that what will be your entry point and what will be the port that you are using. The environment that we are using is flexible environment. The runtime that we are using is Ruby. And there is a .env config file, that is flex-env-config-1. We can save this file. We can define our service name also by defining service. And value can be like anything, something like Ruby demo 2. And for the demo purpose, what I am doing, I am adding one more parameter, manual scaling. And I am giving that maximum instance that it should use will be one only. As our app.yaml configuration is done, next what we need to do is we have to add the .env-raise-jam to your jam file by using the following command: bundle add .env-rails. So as it is done, so the next step is app engine requires permission to load configuration from runtime configuration service at build time. So what we will do, we will just set the project ID first. How we can do it, like export project underscore ID. Our project ID, you can get it from same place that we have copied before. Now we will add IAM policies. So don't worry about this IAM policy. So this is only for the permission so that our UI application can be deployed on the app engine. So this can be done by adding gcloud projects add IAM-policy-binding. Then we can give the project ID that we have, the variable that we have created above. Then we can give the member is equals to service account colon and then the project number. Project number we can get from dashboard only. This will be 5381 and this will be different for you also. We can copy this account key. After that, gcloudbuild.gserviceaccount.com. Then we will define the role as editors. As you have seen, we have run this command successfully and now our cloud build has permission to deploy the Rails application on App Engine. Now only single command is remaining: gcloud app deploy. Now it is asking for confirmation, so we can press yes. Now it will generally take 5 to 6 minutes to deploy your application on App Engine, so we will wait for that time and then our application will be deployed and can be readily used by our users. So after waiting for some time, our application is deployed and we can go to App Engine service account and click on the services. As you can see, it will our welcome page and this application is deployed live on Google Cloud. So if you like my video and want to learn more about Google Cloud, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.